Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of FM Charts for Tuesday, May 20th, 2014. In this presentation, we're looking at four stock picks, starting with Tim Seymour's recommendation to buy Deutsche Bank. The first thing I notice on this chart is the elongated pressure zone across the bottom of the screen, telling me that this stock is broken. So Tim Seymour is doing a little dumpster diving here. Looking for support at 40.63. If that doesn't hold, 37.50 would be our next target to the downside. We had a reversal day yesterday, but nowhere near a buy signal. This is a European stock, so any of the overseas stocks, whether you're looking in Asia or Europe, will gap a lot more than a North American stock because the stock is reacting to news that's already happened outside of market hours. In this stock, we're looking for a close on Tuesday above 42.87 to give us a new buy signal for Deutsche Bank. Dan Nathan's recommending a short on Starbucks. Starbucks has been trading sideways for a while. Possibility of a double bottom here, two major lows. We've got a pressure zone forming, starting to get a little elongated there as we're not seeming to be able to take any flight here. At the same time, he wants to go short and we're not seeing any downward pressure. So we're currently on a buy signal as of last night's close. We'll remain so until we see a daily close below 69.92. If you want to short this stock, then look for a break out of the range, and that would be a close, the first close below 68.75. Next up, we're looking at Karen Finerman's recommendation to short Correction Corp. And this stock has been having a hard time. It's hit the 200-day moving average three times in the last few months, and so wouldn't be surprised if it continued to head lower. We're currently on a sell signal. We've moved down two lines. If we take out 3203, then 3125 would be our next target to the downside. We've been on a sell signal or short this stock for the last couple of days, last week. Close above 32.96 would give us a new buy signal on Tuesday, not expecting to see that happen. Last up this morning, we're looking at Guy Adami's recommendation to buy Abercrombie and Fitch. The stock's been treading water for the last couple of weeks, currently on a buy signal, but unfortunately stuck in the flypaper channel. So a breakout of this triangle should tell us which way we're heading next, or a breakout of this range, whichever you prefer. 39.06 on the upside, 35.94 on the downside. A breakout of 39.06 should take us up two lines to 42.19. We'll remain long this stock until we see a daily close below 36.96. Okay, folks, that's all for today's presentation. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again tomorrow morning.